All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Steve Taylor. He's the CEO of BlueRush. And Steve, welcome back. Nice to see you again. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Steve. Hope you had a happy and safe break with your family.
Yeah, very quiet for sure. But it was not quiet as far as your first quarter numbers are concerned, because you put up some really good ones. Just give us some overall thoughts on that first quarter, Steve.
Yeah. Well, listen, you know, it was an exciting quarter on a lot of levels. And we've been able to, you know, continue to invest in our sales and marketing machine and our product. And we're really starting to see that pay off in terms of our results. And so this quarter was particularly a nice one because we had a good balance of new revenue coming from both our existing clients growing. We had some of our bigger accounts become bigger in the wealth management domain and the insurance domain and banking. And then also we signed some significant new logo customers as well. In the bank, mostly in banking and insurance, but we did get our first, also our first utility customer. Mm-hmm. So using their utility bills or statements to provide customer support, explain the bill, explain how people can change their behaviors to lower their bill, explain payment options, all those kind of things. So new telco client, new utility client, those are new verticals for us. We've been very kind of focused in the financial services domain, and we still are, but, you know, we're starting to see now that we can create value in some of these other verticals. So, you know, great quarter in terms of, you know, new logo revenue, existing customers coming back and growing their relationships. We had zero logo churn in the quarter. We didn't lose any customers. And, you know, I think that's a big health indicator for any SaaS company, you know, is that ability to not only retain, but grow their customers. So couldn't be more pleased.
You obviously want to see that growth continue, you know, into second, third, and then beyond quarters. But I'm wondering, just signing those two new verticals that you talked about, utilities and the other one as well, sometimes it's the one domino chip that falls first that leads the rest to follow behind. And is that the case in the industry, Steve? Is that when you sign up someone with, you know, that's got as big as utility, that other companies start to say, hey, what are they doing? Maybe we should be doing it as well.
That's been the way with the interactive personalized video, you know, since we began. And the good news is I can't give the name away, but the particular utility that we signed in the United States is one of the largest utilities in the United States. They are considered an innovator. And so absolutely the industry's watching what they're doing. But also from our perspective, strategically, this is important to understand, these deals are coming through partners and in these new verticals. So both the telco example, that's in South America through one of our partners there, and Perkis, which is a great partner of ours, and then in the United States through another partner called Nikea DX. And, you know, each of these partners have more customers and the opportunity for a lot of leverage for us. So absolutely, you're right. You get that first one and everybody goes, okay, you know, now we'll try it. But then we've also positioned ourselves to be able to take advantage of that with quite a bit of leverage that we've built into the partner model.
Yeah. And lastly, Steve, it seems to me that just reading through the news release and specifically about, you know, the new clients that you've received and the clients that you've retained as well, which were all of them, is the sector really starting to heat up in your particular line?
This space is starting to really materialize right in front of our eyes. And, you know, we bet a little early on this, but I think probably at the perfect time, because, you know, you've got to be a little bit early to take advantage of an emerging opportunity like this. And, you know, but we're really seeing now, you know, companies come to us ready to buy, you know, like they understand interactive personalized video. I mean, there's a natural reason for these for our company to exist, right? Which is that, you know, all of these marketing teams and sales teams, they want to use personalization. They want to be more contextual and relevant. They have to be. Customers demanding it. On the flip side, they want to use video. And everybody knows video is the most engaging medium. And people prefer video for a whole bunch of types of things in terms of consuming content. And video is just inherently very hard to personalize. That's right. Like, so we've essentially bridged the gap. You know, you can ask, go into one company after another, is personalization an important part of your strategy? Yes. Is video an important part of your marketing and sales strategy? Yes. How are you combining those things? We can't. So enter BlueRush. And so we're filling a beautiful gap, and people are starting to recognize that now. So as I say, the companies are coming with mandates. They're coming, they've learned about it. And, you know, 2 years ago, everything was fully evangelical, educational, handholding, uphill, looking for that first client, Steve, you know, in the vertical, the one to go first that that you can then use to incent everybody else. It's changed significantly.
Yeah. Well, it's super important to be able to go to a client and say, we can't. If you say we can, that usually gets the deal done. So, Steve, thank you so much. Great to see you again. Congratulations, and we'll talk soon.
All right. Thanks, guys.
All right. There's Steve Taylor, the CEO of BlueRush.